Hi again, and this is the third part of our revision. We will be talking about the ER diagram model, and this is of week 5 and week 6. So now we'll be talking about week 5 and 6 because both hold the same topic. Right, again, let's start with some terminologies that are important in this topic. First of all, what is an entity? Okay, an entity is an object that exists in the database. Okay, so it's an object. An object that exists that exists and is distinguished from other objects. Okay, this is an entity. Any object that is that exists in a table or a database and is distinguished from other objects. We also have entity set. We have another terminology that is an entity set. Okay, it's a set of entities of the same type that share the same properties, right? So, for example, so as you said, it's like it's set of entities. I got distracted with the email I just got, so I'm just concentrating on that. Okay, so it's a set of entities of the same type that share the same properties. For example, set of all persons. Okay, for example, set of persons. It's a set of entities. Okay. We also have something called binary relationship. Binary relationship. And in the binary relationship, it means that it involves a relation of two entities. Okay, so that's a binary relationship. It involves the relation of two entities. Most databases adapt the binary relationship. However, we do have non-binary relationship, like ternary relationship, where we have three entities or more involved in the database, but most databases involve or use the binary relationship. We also have a very important topic or terminologies, we have the attribute types. Okay, we have attribute. Attribute types, we have two main types. We have a simple, we have a simple attribute, and we have a composite attribute. The simple is a single valued. Attribute like I don't know, first name. Okay, so if we have a first name as an attribute, so it's just it's a single value. On the other hand, we have a composite attribute, which is a multi-value attribute, as I discussed. And by the way, we also I mean, a composite, it's a multi-value. But a multi-value means something else as well. Meaning that a composite, as we discussed before, it's a non-atomic. It's opposite of atomic attribute. It's a composite attribute. As I discussed before, for example, if we say IT244, it's a composite. It's made up of IT and 244. Okay, IT means something. 244 means another, so it's a composite attribute. Multi-value on the other side, on the other hand, right? Multi-value, meaning that some attributes also can have. We also have, like, let's say we have a multi-value. We have a multi-value attribute. Okay, multi-value attribute. For example, if you have if you have a name, and let's say you have a phone number, right? You have a name and you have a phone number. Now, the phone number is an attribute. It can be a multi-value, meaning that one person, person A, for example, can have more than a phone number, right? Okay, so the phone number here is a multi-value attribute. So you need to know this. So we have a simple attribute, meaning it's a single value. We have a composite, which is a multi-value because it has two values here. It has two parts. It has IT and 244. But multi-value also has another meaning. If we have a multi-value attribute, okay, if we have a multi-value attribute, it means that an attribute can have more than one value. So, like for example, a name against a phone number. So one person can well have more than a phone number. So that's a multi-value attribute, right? Also, we discussed in the chapter, we discussed the relation types. Oops. Relation types. And we said we have four types of relations. We have 1, 2, 1. We have 1, 2, many. We have many, 2, 1. And we have many, too many. Okay, in the one-to-one relationship, we have, for example, if we have these two tables or entities, and they have these attributes here, right? In the one-to-one, is that only one attribute in this table can have a relation with only one attribute in the other table, or one entity can have a relation with one entity, okay, like this, for example. So one entity from one table can have a relation with only one entity in another table. In the one-to-many, okay, it means that one entity can have a relation with more than an entity in the other table. Okay, so an entity in one table on the left hand side can have more than one relation with other entities in the other table. So that's one to many relationship. Okay, on the other hand, let me get a new page. Right, we can also have many to one. Okay, let's say we have two entities here and one here, right? So these two can have a relation with the same attribute or entity on the other one. So that's a many to one relationship. Also, we can have many to many relationship. Okay, so we have attributes here, attributes here, and it's many to many. So, like for example, this attribute, oops, this attribute can have a relation with many attributes, right? And also, for example, let's take these ones. For example, these ones can have a relation with this. Right? So now it's a many-to-many relationship. So you need to know these. We've come across redundant attribute. Just a brief understanding of what redundant attribute is. Redundant is ziyada. Okay, just a quick, just have a quick look at the definition of the redundant attribute. Now, before we move on, we'll just because we're talking about the entity relation diagram. The entity relation diagram has a standard drawing that you may need to know if you get a question, if you get asked a question in the examination maybe draw an entity ER model, diagram or model. So you need to be aware of the symbols or the drawing of that as well, as you were given in the midterm examination. Actually, I'll, at the end of this part, I will present to you the question that you got in the midterm. So we'll solve. There's a solution for that, so which I'll show to you. Okay. So a square is an entity, right? If we have this, it's an entity. شكل المعين. So excuse my drawing. It's not very very symmetrical. It's a relationship. Okay, try it again. This is slightly better. This is a relationship. Attribute is given this oval shape drawing. This is an attribute. Weak entity, right? What do we mean by a weak entity? Weak entity means that we do not have a primary key in this relation, okay, or in this entity. So we do not have, so this is called weak entity. When we say weak entity, we mean that there is no primary key in this entity. Also, we have a weak entity, a weak entity relationship. Sorry, yeah, weak entity relationship. I keep pressing the wrong button. Right, how do I draw this? Right. As the shape that we saw, but you double the line. Okay, excuse my drawing, you double the line. So this is, so I'll try it here. This becomes now a weak entity relationship. We have more shapes, let's have a look. We also have a multi-valued attribute. It can be drawn like this. Again, oval shape, but double the line. So this is a multi-valued attribute. We also have a term called total participation. If we have an attribute here and a relation, okay? If we have a double line, it means total participation, meaning all the attributes that are in this entity must be in relation, okay, with whatever is in here, right? Must be in relation because as we saw earlier, let's go back a bit. As you saw earlier here, not necessarily. Oops, I think I'm going too far. Not necessarily all the relations have sorry, all the attributes have relations. Not necessarily all the attributes have relations. You can have some attributes with the relations. But in some cases, we need all the attributes to be in relations. This is called total participation, and it is shown in like this double line, right? Also, the one-to-one, as you know, if we have one-to-one relationship, so we have this, we have this, and we have this entity. One-to-one relationship is is drawn like an arrow. This is a one-to-one relationship. We also have one-to-many relationship. Okay, this is a one-to-many relationship. We also have the opposite. We have many to one relationship, and finally we have the many to many relationship. Also, we could the attributes in the entity can either, for example, this is an entity. This is an entity square. Okay, start again. Okay, this is an entity. We either write the attributes inside, like a list, or we can attach them in oval shapes. Okay, these are also entities that belong to the attribute. Composite attributes can be done like this. So if you have this entity, and you are asked to draw a composite attribute, for example, the IT244, so we have here IT244, right? Now, because IT244 is a composite, you can expand it further, and you'll have 244 here, and you will have IT here. So this is a composite attribute, okay? So this stuff that you need to know, right? Let's see what else we have. Now, redundancy of a schema, the design issues on slide 44, converting non-binary to binary, all this stuff, I don't think they will crop up on your examination paper. So you don't need to concentrate on those. Redundancy of a schema, design issues, and converting non-binary to binary, you will not get this on your examination paper for this final examination. Okay. Briefly, you need to know and understand the extension of ER feature. For example, the specialization. The specialization and generalization. You need to know this. It's a very very close to what you studied before in Java when it came to inheritance. And we have specialization, generalization. So you need to understand those. And I'm sure most of you are familiar with this because you've already studied the meaning of specialization and generalization in Java. So you may need to refer to them again. Also, you will need to know these terminologies in your slides again. The meaning of disjoint, what does disjoint mean? Overlapping, and the word constraint. comes a lot. Okay, so you will need to know these terminologies. Okay, they may come as an MCQ or true or false or whatever. So you need to know these. On the other hand, you do not need to know the aggregation in this chapter. I think you'll get a question on aggregation. Unified modeling language UML. Make yourself familiar with it. Okay, and the difference between the UML and the ER diagram. So you need to know the modeling unified modeling language UML. And understand briefly that it's just, the diagrams are much pretty similar to the ones you've studied in the ER diagram, but you need to be aware of them just in case. Okay, now before we finish this part, let us take the example as we promised. Okay, if you have a look here. I think we had this question in the previous examination, your midterm examination. It says use an ER diagram to design a database for a football match. So it's only one match, a football match, that the database must store the match, team, and the players' details along with the match results and as the following. So we made it clear for you that you had entity match. So match is an entity. Right, so these were parameters for the question. معطيات للسؤال. So entity match. So match, we know match is an entity. We know team is an entity, and we know player is an entity. Okay, so that's good. And we also we made it clear that player is a relationship. Played is a relationship. Match team is a relationship, and player team is a relationship. So it's pretty much solved in this regard, right? And we also gave you all the attributes that are in each one of them. So for the entity match, you know that you need to create an entity called match, and you put attributes. You either put attributes as a list in the entity, or as I explained before, you can have them as oval shapes surrounding the entity. We had the match ID. Now we've also specified here that the match ID is a primary key. So can you see a solid line? There's a solid line underneath the match ID, explaining that this is a super key. This is a primary key. Okay. Also, we have entity. Well, let's talk about player now. Player has the attributes player ID, and player ID is primary key. So as you can see, there's a solid line underneath it, right? And there's a relation which is played. So if you look at the played, is a relationship between match and a player, right? So we created a played relationship between the match and the player. And it includes the following attributes: the match ID, player ID, and a score. Now, if you note something, that the match ID and the player ID both can be we can fetch them from the entities match and player. The only attribute that we do not have in this relation, this one. We do not have the score. So we're just going to have to add the score to this relationship. Okay, so we just have to add the score. Because again, match ID and the player ID, they already exist. We have them in the match, and we have them in the player entities. While the score, we don't have it, so we have to include it. Right, so this relationship. And also, it's a common sense that it's a one-to-many relationship. Why? It's only one match played by more than a player, right? So it's only one match played by more than a player. Also, if we have a look, that we have the team entity. It has the name and the session and season status whatever, right? And also the team has a relationship. It has a player team. It's a relationship between the team and the player, and it has the match team, a relationship between the match and the team. Is the same again, same principle as you can see. And also here we have a many-to-many relationship because many teams, there are two teams obviously playing one match, and both have many players, so it's a many-to-many relationship. And the match and the team, I think this can be okay, yeah, team and a match is also the team, the relationship between the team and the match is also many one to many, so it's only one match played by many teams, which are two teams. Okay, so this is how you design. So if you get a question, read the parameters and very well, and based on the parameters, design your model. So this is the ER model for the this is the answer for the ER question that you you had in your midterm examination. Okay, so that's it for this part. I'll see you in the next part.